Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Ton Does Linux, your source for what's new and what matters in the open source world. The first week of December has been absolutely packed with significant developments that will shape the Linux ecosystem for years to come. We've got a brand new long-term support kernel that just dropped, a fan-favorite lightweight distro getting a massive update, NVIDIA is finally making some serious moves on Wayland, and Linux gaming on Steam has just smashed another record. So grab your coffee, settle in, and let's break down the biggest Linux news of the week. First up, and arguably the biggest news of the week, Linux Kernel 6.18 is here, and it has officially been crowned the new long-term support, or LTS, release. For those new to this, an LTS kernel is a huge deal. This means this version will be maintained with bug fixes and critical security patches for at least the next 2 years, until December 2027. This is the kernel that major distributions like Ubuntu LTS, Debian, and enterprise systems will build upon for maximum stability. It's the foundation for the future. So what's inside? Kernel 6.18 brings some fantastic new features under the hood. There's now support for the Rust binder driver, a big step forward toward incorporating memory-safe languages into the kernel. We also have a new device mapper target called DMPcache, which allows you to use persistent memory as a super-fast cache for slower block devices. Think Optane-style performance boosts for your storage. And for you system tweakers, a new microcode is command line option gives you more granular control over how your CPU's microcode is loaded on x86 platforms. As the new LTS king is crowned, we say goodbye to an old one. Linux 5.4, which has been maintained for over 6 years, has officially reached end of life. It's a testament to the kernel developers' incredible work. A new LTS kernel is excellent, but what's a kernel without a distro to run it? And right on cue, one of our favorite lightweight champions, Alpine Linux, has released version 3.23, which ships with the brand new Linux 6.18 LTS right out of the box. Alpine is famous for being tiny, secure, and incredibly fast, making it a top choice for containers and embedded systems. But it's also a fantastic desktop OS if you value minimalism and performance. This release is a major one, bringing the APK 3.0 package manager after years of development. It's also systemd free for those who prefer the OpenRC init system. And despite its small size, Alpine 3.23 is packed with the latest desktop environments, offering GNOME 49 and KDE Plasma 6.5. A full XFCE desktop install can use as little as 200 megabytes of RAM. That's just incredibly efficient. Of course, Alpine wasn't the only distro to release a new version. We also saw updates from Oracle Linux with version 10.1, a new Arch Linux ISO for December, and fresh spins from Q4OS and KDE Neon. Speaking of desktops, the updates in Alpine 3.23 to GNOME 49 and KDE Plasma 6.5 reflect the rapid pace of development on the Linux desktop. While we didn't see a major point release from the big desktop projects themselves this week, their inclusion in new distros shows how quickly the ecosystem is moving. On the application front, the 9-to-5 Linux weekly roundup was filled with notable updates. VLC Media Player version 3.0.22 arrived with a cool new AMD GPU framerate doubler filter. The powerful audio editor Audacity received an update to version 3.7.6, adding support for FFmpeg 8. And for you ebook lovers, Calibre 8.16 was released, adding even more AI-powered features for managing your library. It's this constant churn of improvements across the entire software stack that makes the Linux desktop so exciting to follow. Let's talk hardware. And the big story this week comes from Teen Green. NVIDIA has released the first public beta for its 590 series Linux driver. And it's all about Wayland. For years, NVIDIA's Wayland support has been a work in progress. this new driver, version 590.44.01, takes a significant step forward. It fixes a long-standing bug with the PowerMiser settings panel on Wayland and improves Vulkan swap chain performance, which should reduce stuttering when you resize game or application windows. It's not perfect yet, and this is still a beta, but it's a clear signal that NVIDIA is getting serious about making its Wayland experience as good as its X11 support. In other hardware news, TUXEDO Computers launched a beast of a machine, the Gemini 17 Gen 4. This is an actual desktop replacement laptop for Linux users. It packs an Intel Core i9-14900HX processor, an NVIDIA RTX 5070 Ti GPU, up to 96 gigs of RAM, and a stunning 17-inch 240Hz QHD display. This is a no-compromise machine for developers, creators, and gamers who want top-tier performance on a Linux-first platform. It's incredible to see dedicated Linux hardware vendors pushing the envelope like this. Okay, it wouldn't be a 2025 tech roundup without talking about AI. The Raspberry Pi Foundation just announced major software updates for its AI hardware, the AI Hat Plus and the AI Kit, which are both based on Halo AI accelerators, now have full support in the latest Trixie version of Raspberry Pi OS. The team has cleverly decoupled the driver from the kernel, using DKMS, making the entire software stack more flexible. They've also added a much-requested feature to the AI camera, input tensor injection. This is a fancy term that means developers can now easily feed their own datasets directly to the camera's neural network for debugging and validation. It's a huge step toward making AI development at the edge more accessible and powerful for everyone. And finally, let's talk about the community. And the big win this week is for Linux gaming. According to the latest Steam hardware survey for November 2025, Linux usage has hit another all-time high, now sitting at 3.2%. This is a massive achievement. For years, Linux struggled to break the 1% barrier. The launch of the Steam Deck was a catalyst, but the growth hasn't stopped. It's a clear sign that Valve's investment in Proton and the Steam OS ecosystem is paying off, bringing more and more gamers over to the Linux side. It was the only operating system to gain market share on Steam last month. The momentum is real, and it's fantastic to see. So there you have it, a new LTS kernel providing a stable base for years to come. Lightweight distros pushing the boundaries of efficiency, hardware vendors delivering powerful Linux machines, and a gaming ecosystem that is growing faster than ever. It's an exciting time to be a Linux user. The pace of innovation is just relentless, and the community is stronger than ever. What news are you most excited about? Let me know down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video and want to stay up to date on all things Linux, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.